Hey internet, this is Perry reporting for TSG for my third time. My camera's giving me the hardest time today, so I don't know, this is like the 10th time I've recorded this video in full. It's my last day here in Kingston, Ontario at the AKA Autonomous Social Center. I've had a really good month. I'm posting my video early because I'm leaving tomorrow to go to Toronto, so I won't have time to make and post a video, but I'm gonna be in Toronto for a week and then head back to Montreal, go to Halifax for a bit, and then back to Montreal to table at a zine fair with Morgan C. So if you're gonna be in any of those cities, you can let me know and maybe we could hang out. Especially, I don't really know anyone in Halifax, I've never been there, so let me know. This week was Morgan's topic, and it was go back in the TSG vaults and choose an old topic. So I went through them and I picked TSG 136 for my video because I feel like I'm still introducing myself to you folks, and I thought it was a really introductory question, really good question. It was submitted by Vella, and it was, how did you choose your name? And then the bonus question was, at what age did you realize you were trans? So there are two reasons why I really chose Perry. It's the second time I've changed my name since I've been trans. And it really just started as a joke between my boyfriend and I. Said if I were to change my name again, it'd be the gayest name ever. And it'd be Periwinkle, because it's a dandy little flower and it's a dandy little color. And we live with like 8 to 10 people, so everyone just started calling me Perry. I started getting phone calls and emails checking in about my name. And it just went from there. Like, now I just found myself introducing myself as Perry. So, and I really like it. It's my favorite fruit as well. So I like when people call me Pear. It's cute. Fruity little genderqueer boy. I like that. It also rhymes with the nursery rhyme. It's like, Mary, Mary, quite contrary. And I can be quite contrary. I'm a little bit stubborn. I'm opinionated. You know, I kind of rail against everything. Anti-capitalist, anti-assimilationist, androgynous, genderqueer kid of some sort. So I like it, Perry Contrary. And the other name I go by is Jesse Crass. I don't dislike that name, I still go by it, but I don't like being, everyone always thinks I affiliate with Crass the band, that terrible punk band that sold out, so I don't want to be affiliated with them. It started because I am Crass, but anyways, you can call me Perry, it's great. I feel like I've known I was trans since I was a kid, since I was like 4 or 5, but back then, you know, it was just like in my mind, I couldn't admit that it was like something that was going to be with me for the rest of my life. I thought for me, it was like really connected to my queerness. And I just was like, you know, I'll grow out of this, you know, I'm having all these weird feelings for all these different gendered people, and I'm just going to have to like get over it. And as soon as I hit puberty, I'm going to have to grow up. So I really consciously suppressed any sort of like gender identity stuff I was going through, because I couldn't tell my parents, and I was gonna hit puberty, and there was no point. I just had all these things that I felt were working against me. And so I didn't really learn about what trans or genderqueer or anything like that was until I was 17 or 18, and I met people when I moved to a different town who were like me, and were really supportive, and like taught me all these words about like how I was feeling. So I started explicitly identifying as genderqueer and trans when I was about 20, but I've definitely felt this way for a really long time, and I'm really still working through my gender stuff. I mean, I don't really know what my transition is, and I feel really insecure about it a lot of the time, as I've talked about in other videos, because I'm not a super buff dude who's on T. Not that like I think there's anything wrong with that, it's more the other way around. I feel like I should be doing something else, so I'm gonna keep working through those things and eventually get somewhere. So I'm gonna leave it at that. I'm wearing the same outfit as last week, which is kind of embarrassing, but I want to go through my pack and put something else on, so don't hate, appreciate. I hope you like my video, and I hope you all have a really, really, really good weekend. Thanks for watching. Bye.